Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
He would have spoken about me, but you know, I also need to reciprocate it. When I joined the academy for preparing for civil services, there is hardly any motivation that you will have. Those days, people never used to share like, you know, what we need to study. There used to be guys who will have two sets of books. One set of books which you read, you will clear. There is another set of books which you read, you will never clear. So whenever you knock someone's door for a guidance, they'll keep all these big books on their tables. Like they'll be keep reading, okay? When we enter and when we ask them, like, no, enna padikkanum, what we should read, they'll give you that big book. It will take you 1 year to finish that big book. So after some time, you will also feel you will not become confident. You feel like, no, it may take some more years and all. So during that period, the first photograph which inspired me that I should get into civil services was a photograph of Israel. So he was in railways. Yeah. He was in railways. He sent those photographs to Kingsley. So Kingsley was my guide. Later he became my friend. So like he sent it to Kingsley. Kingsley showed it to me. Then he was telling like, no, Israel, he's my friend. Labasna photographs. Now when I'm coming down, I was seeing the same photograph there. It was a nostalgic feel. And thanks to you, you have been one of the inspirations for me. So I'm happy to come. I don't know what to speak about. You want me to speak about police? You want me to speak about preparing for civil services? What do you want me to speak about?
Police.
Yeah. I hate to do that. Okay. You guys are preparing for one of the easiest exams in the world. Do you believe it? Huh? In Tamil, I used to tell to all my friends, எந்த வேலை கிடைக்கலாம் கவலைப்படாத ஐஏஎஸ் ஐபிஎஸ் ஆகிடலாம். Do you accept it? You accept it or not? If I say that is a truth, what do you think? According to me, the easiest job that you can get is civil services. I am the example for that. Okay? As Israel said, I was not a topper. I did my engineering, passed with arrears. Some have passed in 4 years, not a very studious guy, not a topper and all. Seen as one of the failure in my family. Sariya, ponnu kuda kudukka matenga. Okay. That was the status in my family, okay. Then. So I finished my college. From my childhood, I had this ambition, you know, I should prepare for civils. So I straight away came for preparing for civil services. So first year, I didn't clear. The first year, my option was electrical engineering. So that time, we don't have all these institutes, so we don't have any knowledge about how to prepare and all. So edutachi electrical engineering, mathematics, thinking like that. Then one person told me, you please opt for geography. Now you don't have optionals for prelims, right? During our times, we used to have an optional subject for prelims. So my option was geography. So I opted for geography. Then that year, I cleared civil services. In 2003, I got into Indian Police Service, very easily. At the age of 24, I was an IPS officer. How many of you are here above 24? For all. So there are many people, you have chances to become an IAS or IPS officer at the age of 24. Okay, because you are younger than that. That means you have been fresh from the college. Next year, so when I got into IPS, I was thinking that I'll get Tamil Nadu. So I decided not to write again. Because enough, ramba padichache. I left it, okay. So when all my friends were writing exams next year, I just came to say all the best for them. I came from Nagarkoil, from Kanyakumari. I came here for prelims. Then suddenly they told me that I'm getting Tripura posting. I'm getting cadre of Tripura. I thought I'll get Tamil Nadu. They told me Tripura. I was not so happy to go to some other place. I was happy in Tamil Nadu. So then I also wrote the exam. My second prelims, I finished in some 30-40 minutes. 40 minutes, I finished my paper, gave it, came out. They'll not send you, so I was coming out and speaking with the invigilator. He thought that I'm one of the guys who have not studied anything. So that is why I put randomly some ABCDs. ஐயோ அது என்னப்பா படிக்கலையா? ஐ வாஸ் ஆல்சோ எனக்கு படிக்கல சார், திடீர்னு வந்தேன் சார். யூ டோன்ட் நோ பை தென் ஐ வாஸ் அன் ஐபிஎஸ் ஆஃபீஸர், ஹி ஹஸ் நோ ஐடியா. ஓகே, ஆல் த கைஸ் ஹவ் பீன் இன் த ரூம், தே ஆல் நோ பிகாஸ் வி ஆல் அப்ளை டுகெதர். ஸோ ஆல் அவர் ரெஜிஸ்டர் நம்பர்ஸ் வேர் டுகெதர், ஸோ எவ்ரி ஒன் இஸ் அ ஃப்ரெண்ட். ஸோ அப்படி இப்படின்னு சொல்லி நல்லா படிக்கணும் தம்பி, அப்படின்னா வேலைக்கு போனோம். எஸ் சார் ஐ டூ தேட். ஸோ கைண்ட் ஆஃப் கன்வர்சேஷன் வாஸ் கோயிங் ஆன். ஓன்லி இன் த எண்ட் அதர் கைஸ் டோல்ட் ஹிம் லைக் நோ ஹி ஹஸ் ஆல்ரெடி கிளியர்ட் ஐபிஎஸ் அவுட். See guys, like I finished in 30 minutes, cleared that prelims. For mains, Israel was writing his next attempt, Israel, Kingsley and all. For Kingsley, that was the last attempt. It was his seventh attempt. If you don't clear, he's finished. So what I used to do, I used to lock Kingsley in his room. We both are roommates. Ulunga padi. Velil on the Israel, Israel, get a patient rik pora. Don't speak with Israel and all. Sit inside room and you study. Okay, I lock Kingsley. I go out. I go with my college mates because the 2 years, they don't know where I was. So I roam with my college mates and came. That's how I wrote my mains. That also I cleared. Now I the mains and cleared pantong. Then I went for interview. Initially I thought, okay, well, let us not go for interview because by then I was in Tamil Nadu cadre. I was in IPS, National Police Academy. Our National Police Academy was a very posh academy, posher than ITC hotel. They treat you like a king. Okay, you will feel a different, elated feel. I was like that, so very, very happy. So no idea of going for any interview and all. But the training used to be very tough. Only for this interview, they'll give leave. So 2 days, you can sleep a little late. Otherwise, you have to wake up at 5 o'clock. I felt like that is good. From a childhood, my parents told me, nalla padichina, nalla velaikku polam. You study well, you can go for good job. வாட் இஸ் எ குட் ஜாப்? நல்ல வேலை கிடச்சிச்சுன்னா மெதுவாக இருந்திருக்கலாம். ஸோ மார்னிங் ஐ யூஸ் டு வேக் அப் எவ்ரி டே ஏர்லி மார்னிங் இன் மை சைல்டுஹுட். நான் 4 மணிக்கு 5 மணிக்கு எந்திரிச்சு படித்தா மெதுவாக போகலாம். அண்ட் ஐ காட் இன் டு ஐபிஎஸ் அண்ட் ஐம் ஃபோர்ஸ் டு வேக் அப் அகைன் அட் 5 o'clock. நோ டில் டுடே ஐம் வேக்கிங் அப் லைக் தட். ஸோ அதனால் வந்து வென் தே சைட் லைக் நோ யூ கேன் கெட் 2 டேஸ் லீவ். ஃபார்ச்சுனேட்லி பிட்வீன் மை இன்டர்வியூ டேட் அண்ட் மை மெடிக்கல் எக்ஸாமினேஷன் தெர் இஸ் 5 டேஸ். So I can go out of my academy for 5 days and be in Delhi or meet all my friends. So I said, okay, go for interview. I went for interview. The first question was, I want to join IAS. I said, no. Then he said, like, then why did you come? I said, for leave. The interviewer got irritated. He said, why you don't want IAS? I said, I'm not hopeful of getting Tamil Nadu because I have not studied very seriously. I randomly answered. I came up to this. So anyway, I'll not get Tamil Nadu. In police, I'm in Tamil Nadu. I'm happy in my own place. So I don't want to join. Then he saw me for some time. He asked me, okay, what is the advantage of being in Tamil Nadu? I told blah, 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 blah. Then he listened everything. Then he said, get out. He was pissed off of me. He gave me the least marks. My first entry was 207 for 250. That was one of the highest. My second entry was 100. That is one of the least. With that 100, I was into Indian Foreign Service in 2004. So I didn't study it. I wrote my prelims fast. I did my mains casually. I have not studied. I went for interview and answered like that. Still, I was into Indian Foreign Service. But I stick to my old decision. I'll be in police. I'll be in Tamil Nadu. Foreign nam gottukade. I can't eat these pizzas, burgers. I want biryani. Okay, now also you got me a biryani. Okay, and now you tell me, can you write any exam like this and can you clear? Then which is the easiest exam? Civil services and see boss. When I did BE, I was not able to get selected in any campus. All software companies rejected me. 2000 was like, you know, Y2K problem. I finished my college in 2000. So no jobs were flooding. With that jobs, I was not able to get any job. I was not able to get the job of a clerk. I was not able to get the job of an RBI exam. Not able to get the job of short service commission. In all these exams, I failed. The only exam I cleared was civil services. So now, which is the easiest exam? Which is the easiest exam? Huh? So you believe in me? You believe in me? So you all accept it? Huh? Sound early. Which is the easiest exam? Huh? Civil services. Yeah, which is the toughest? The short service commission group 4 la toughest ma. Amava illaya? Because I failed in that, I passed in this. Correct illaya? So all with me? Ne sound e kaanum. Okay, now I'll tell you why. You want to know why? Right? I'll tell you my own story. When I was preparing for civil services, I can't tell you about your stories. You have to listen to my story. Thorayma ethana per apply pannuvanga? How many of them would have every year applying for civil services? Huh? Ethana?
10
lakhs, okay. So how many competitors you have? How many? 10 lakhs. Liya, how many applicants are competing with you? 10 lakhs. Out of these 10 lakhs, there are many people who think just by applying for civil services, they become collector. The 10 lakhs, 50% of people are like that, boss. 50% of people like that. They would have been applied for, they would have been opting and electrical engineering. Maybe option illati me, they may not know anything about civil services. They'll apply for every exam. So they'll also apply for civil services. We think that, you know, we passed among 10 lakh people applied and I became rank number 50, 60, got into IAS, blah, blah, that is all humbug. 50% of the guys would have been preparing for group 4 sitting in Kanimara library. But he will tell that I'm preparing for civil services. His main aim was only to get into some government job. Okay, now remaining 5 lakhs. Okay. How many of you think that you can clear this year? Epom prelims? Huh? May 31. How many of you think that you can clear this year? Be honest. Okay. Can just look around. How many of them have raised it? Nalla, who all can clear this year? How many raise their hands? How many raise their hands? Ethana per kai thookirukanga? Huh? 50%. When you are all preparing in an academy where you need to have confidence that I'll clear this year. Even those who are studying here, only 50% of you have raised your hands that I'll clear this year. So here itself, 50% of the people don't have confidence that they'll clear. Even if they clear, that is a luck. They don't have confidence, okay? They'll not clear mains. So only 50% of the person will put full efforts till the end. Okay, the moment you joined Officers Academy, and the first 50% I told, no? The moment they join, they think that they'll become collectors. The remaining 50% will come to Academy every day. So, they'll tell to all their families. So, what is your name? Huh? Where is Maithili going? Maithili, enna pandranga? Collector padikiranga. And Maithili was very happy with that boss. What is she doing? What is she doing? Satyama. Collector padikiranga. That gets into her head. Sorry, ma'am. Okay. That gets into one's head, okay? So she'll behave in our house also like that only. She'll not speak to her sister. Because her sister is only doing medicine. Yunga collector padikiranga. So she'll ill treat him, okay? In the mari. So half of the people, ungala nari pera pidirukingala illaya? Unmai solnom. How many of you think you become collectors? How many of you behave like that in your home? Okay, so they'll have all these things. So this again spoils our way of preparation. By thinking so, what we do, we get into unnecessary arguments. We'll speak on every issue. We discuss about CAA. How many of you discuss about CAA? What is CAA? Huh? You don't know, huh? Good, yeah. You know it or not? I want an answer from this side, ma. They are the people who have not raised their hands. What is CAA? Someone has to give a bold answer. What is that? Sir, if you don't know, I'm very happy. Okay. So we discuss about CAA, we discuss about good, we discuss about bad, which will not get you a single mark in civil services. Okay. Every morning we will read newspaper, ma. We will take Hindu. Okay, some people start with front page or some people will go to the editorial column. How many of you are reading newspapers? All of you are going to fail. Okay. You will read newspapers. How much time you spend? Someone who is reading newspaper, can you just stand up? Someone. Don't mistake me. I'm trying to, you know, say like what are the mistakes, common mistakes we do. Whoever is reading newspaper, can you just get? Some bold fellow, yeah, if I would have been in your place, I would have got up now. Yeah, good man. Right, okay. You read newspaper, okay? How much time you spend?
1 hour to 1.5 hours
you spend for a newspaper, okay? So, what all you read in a newspaper? You read editorials. What are you going to, what type of exam you are going to give? In civil services, what are you going to write? You are going to give prelims, right? What is prelims about? What kind of questions are asked in prelims? Multiple choice questions. There are four bars. There are four options. You have to select one. What kind of questions are asked in MCTQ, whatever it is? Okay. What kind of questions is asked? It is either fact-based, correct? It is either fact-based or it is a concept-based. Do any concepts or facts come in newspaper? Do any facts or concepts come in editorial? Is it coming? Is it coming? Where? Okay. How many marks is for general studies? In prelims, how many marks is there for general studies? In a general studies paper, in your paper, that you know that there will be 20 questions coming from geography, there will be questions coming from history, correct? There will be some questions coming from current affairs. Only these questions coming from current affairs will be there in newspaper. Will you have your geography questions in newspaper? Will you have your history questions? Will you have your economics questions? Only current affairs. What is the number of marks for current affairs? Yavla? 20, 25. So 25 marks. For 25 marks, you are spending 1.5 hours every day. Does it worth? Very simple. Does it worth? Then why I am doing it? Because I am preparing for civil services. I am supposed to read newspaper. If you are not supposed to read newspaper, my parents think that I am not preparing for civil services. Nah. So orgette. See nah. We keep newspaper. Okay. So boss, don't do this. Every moment is precious for civil services. Now I'll tell you, like, during my times, there used to be some magazines like Chronicle, Chanakya and all. You have such magazines now? Whatever comes in these newspapers, they'll collect everything, they'll finish it in one page. Okay? It comes once in a month. So whatever is coming for civil services exam, that is being comprehended, given in one page, in one magazine. That magazine also I will not read fully, in only one page. Next magazine comes next month. So for this 1 month, I read this one page every day. It covers the entire civil current affairs of the 1 month. There is no need that I need to mug up. Among the four questions, what is the capital of Peru? What is the capital of Peru? There is no need that I need to remember Lima. I don't remember that. But I know that something starts with L and it is a small word. I am clearing my civil services. I am clearing my prelims. For that, I need to see that again and again and again. There are different types of learning, okay? You learn by reading it. You learn by just looking into it. So I am seeing the page again and again and again. Whereas I am reading a newspaper, I am wasting time in unnecessary arguments, in unnecessary opinions, which is of no use for me. Right? So, me, I don't know what Israel told you or what this institute is telling you, but how I prepared, I'm going to tell you. I have never read any newspaper for the next 2 years. When you read a new, when you need to read newspaper, when you're going for an interview, it is not even useful when you are writing mains. Okay, for essay, it is little bit, editorial and all. That is also humbug. And I was going for an interview. For my arguments with the interviewer, I need to have the knowledge. I need to know different opinions. So I need to be thorough with the newspaper. So after my mains, I started reading my newspapers regularly so that I can argue myself well. Whereas many of us will start preparing for this interview when? At the time of preparation of prelims. So instead of preparing for prelims, I'm preparing for interview. Certainly, if you go for interview, you'll clear. But unfortunately, you can't go. You have to go for the prelims. And you have wasted your time. This is one of the biggest mistakes that we do during preparation of civil services times. Then second thing what I did was like, you know, I have not gone for too many books. I listed minimum books of mine. So when I've gone for geography, now you don't have the prelims concept, but mains is different. So I've listed like, you know, my syllabus is this. I'll finish all my NCRT books. NCRT, I'm thorough. This page to that page, anything you ask, perfect. I would have read the book 100 times. First time when I read the book, I don't try to understand what it is. But when I'm reading about clouds, I'm going through Gochanglia, I'll not try to understand what is cirrus, what is cumulus. No, I'm an engineering graduate. Those times we don't have classes like this. There is no one to teach. We have to prepare ourselves. I try to understand what kind of terminologies are there in that. So gada 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 and padichu mudichuven. Like, you know, I'll finish Gochanglia in one day. I'll just throw it. All my friends here, no? They'll be reading it for 1 month. What is your name, Thambi?
Shyam.
So think Shyam is my roommate. I finished Gochang Liang and one day and throwing it. Shyam got tensed. Ayyo, anna vachi padichitiya? I said, yeah, yeah, I finished. Shyam cannot sleep for next 5 days. One competition is eliminated. Okay. This is one side, right? Second side is, see, my confidence is getting increased that I finished Gochang Liang. I had physical geography, Savindra Singh. Okay, I finished Savindra Singh. I finished my entire NCRT. I finished all these things. By the end, there is a correlation between each, maybe between physical geography, human geography, there are few relationships. By reading everything, now I'm having a holistic idea about what geography is, what speaks. Then when I was reading for the second time, I used to go a little slow. Then I used to apply it in my surroundings. Then I tried to understand it. What is that? What is the meaning of nimbo? Okay, nimbo is water. So wherever there is a cloud and there is nimbo, there is water. So whenever there is water, then the rain comes. Okay. So anything they ask in multiple question answers about rain and clouds, if there is nimbo, tick it. Okay, what is cirrus? What is cumulus? Okay, make some na. Cumulus, Tamil, it's a cumulus. So anything is like this, it is cumulus. See, I've studied it in 2002, guys. Now, almost 20 years, I'm still able to remember it. It is because I have not by-hearted it, okay? So anything, you can test me in geography even today. Certainly, I'll be better than most of you, right? And then second time, when you go slowly like that, when you understand it, then the facts also you will remember, the concepts also you will remember. And I'm also confident that I finished it once. So I was not afraid. I was not tensed. Ayyo, enna ivula padikala, ivula padikala. I have not yet finished so much. I don't have the tension in me. Second thing, I'll go slow. Once I finished my second reading, then I started writing my own test. Okay, every chapter I took, I started writing my test. Then I started understanding where I'm lacking in my concepts. I was not checking with anyone else. It is all self-preparation. Then third, fourth, fifth. Then on the day of exam, on one day, I can read every book because I'm very thorough. I know every page. I can just go through like that. In human geography, we had a question in my exam. So in everyone's opinion, the answer was different. In my opinion, the answer was different. It's a concept-based. And everyone was giving me a reasoning. Ibbidi, ibbidi, ibbidi. I was telling them, you know, in the book, in the page, on the page, because I've read that book so many times, that, you know, I know very well what he speaks about. It was a little confusing. So that easy is civil services, but you have to plan it a little bit. But when you are preparing for civil services, everything should be civil services. People ask me, how many hours you study, sir? Ninga yarkitta ketirukingla? Anyone who has come here, have any of you asked, sir, how many years you prepare? Ketirukingla, Ipma adhu? Ketirukingla? Okay, how many hours you prepare? How many hours you prepare, boss? 7 hours. Hey, podumaya. Oh, for all. You are only in prelims, no? Mains ka? No need, boss. See, I'm telling you. I'm preparing for mains from now onwards. If I'm not able to clear my prelims, what is the use of me being so strong in my mains? You understand that? We all giving some time for mains. Every day, 1 hour, 2 hours, I'm ready reading mains. But I'm not able to clear my prelims. What is the use? I'm very good in my mains. What is the use? I have not selected my mains option till I finish my prelims. I finish my prelims, I got my result. In my village, there is no internet, boss. Then, I gave all my numbers to a classmate of mine who is in Chennai. Result paathrena. If I fail, if my friend understands that I failed, I don't want to have an embarrassment. So what I did, I gave him 10 numbers. All different friends. Give me the results of all these 10 people. Whom I want them also fail if I fail. Okay. If anyone passes, I thought, okay, then we should not tell any results. In the 10 numbers, I gave my number in the middle. I have not given it as a first number or last number. This idiot called me. Apply fail, I did. I thought I got failed. At my home, you know, already we have a great reputation. Things started, okay. Modal naal, rendava naal, moonava naal. Then suddenly my friend called me on third day. He know that nanbanilia, depressed arpam, paavam. Okay, he was working as a software engineer. Getting 30,000 in 2000 is like getting some 2 lakhs now. Was getting 30,000 then. He was working in IBM. So he gave me a call. I was like, no, call Pradamakla, Advati Pathaklam, we'll do next time. If your parents are not sponsoring, I am there to sponsor you. How much you want? We are there, you come back to Chennai, that, this and all. I was also, in the end, he told, but among the numbers you gave, one fellow passed. No tension raised in me. But when I failed, who is that fellow who passed? I don't want anyone else to pass. Okay, and then I said, numbers only. When he entered the number, it was my number. Today, ஏன்னா முதலியே சொல்லல அன்னைக்கே சொல்லியிருக்கலாம்லடா ஒருத்தன் பாஸ் பண்ணான்னு சொல்லி இசர் இல்லடா ஈ தாட் தட் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் நம்பர் உட் ஹவ் பீன் யுவர் நம்பர் ஸோ தட் நம்பர் ஃபெயில் ஸோ ஐ டோன்ட் வாண்ட் டு டெல் தட் ஒன் ஹாஸ் பாஸ்ட் நீ ஃபீல் பண்ணல வச்சு அதனால சொல்லல ஏ அடா பாவி ஸோ ஐ வாஸ் ஒன் ஹூ பாஸ்ட் ஓகே தென் ஐ ஹவ் டு ரீசெக் இட் ட்வைஸ் த்ரைஸ் தென் ஐ ஸ்டார்டட் ஐ கேம் பேக் டு சென்னை பை தென் ஆல் த ரூம்ஸ் காட் ஃபில்ட் இட்ஸ் அ கவர்மெண்ட் இன்ஸ்டியூட் தே கேவ் இட் ஃபார் ஹூ எவர் இஸ் இன் மைன்ஸ் ஆஃப்டர் கம்மிங் டு இன்ஸ்டியூட் Then I started deciding what is my second option. Then my second option I choose the psychology was. When I took psychology as my second option, there is no one to teach psychology in Chennai. You will not get any material. They said you have to go only to Delhi. So after clearing claims, after taking a break, I went to Delhi. I finished my course in Delhi, psychology. I cleared both. So for mains, that much of time is enough. Now you have only one option. So you don't have two options also. The burden is very, very less. So first think of the first step. What is the first step? At least, okay, now you are preparing for mains. I don't want to discourage you. Okay, but have a cutoff date. January vandirchi. After January, I will not concentrate on my mains. I will concentrate only on my prelims. Okay, it's target oriented. Now I have to finish. Whatever mains, I will try to finish it before December. After December, because I need to clear prelims, yaar. If I'm good in interview, if I'm good in mains, what is the use? I need to clear prelims. So I spend my entire time in prelims. Okay. So how much time I spend for prelims? I spent my 24 hours for this exam. It is not 1 hour, 2 hours, 7 hours, 10 hours. Why I say 24 hours? Adhenna sir, 24 hours padichittey irundhingala? No, yaar, I had taken food. But when I'm having food, why I'm having food? If I don't take food, I'll not have energy to read. So it is not that I'm having my food because I was hungry. I'm having food, otherwise it disturbs my study pattern. So my entire, whatever I do, it is oriented towards preparing. Okay. Abdi prelims padikkum bodhu, there was a movie came. Alagi appdin solli or movie. Have you heard of that movie? By then we all would have been in schools, correct? அஞ்சாம் கிளாஸ் ஆறாம் கிளாஸ் படிச்சுன்னு இருப்பீங்க ஓகே வெரி ஃபேமஸ் மூவி யார் everyone was speaking about that movie. I was determined, even if fail our candidates, let them all go for a movie. If they are all going for a movie, they are all wasting 24 hours. I can read more. So now I will pass, all these fellows fail. So I was very happy, everyone is going for a movie. I was sitting only with the book and staring. Book la ukandirukren, from book nothing is going on. I know that I'll finish that book in one day, but that particular day, even one page was not going on. Only that movie is coming. Enada irukku andha movie, enada irukku andha movie, enada. Then I decided, indha padam paathu mudikira variki, until you finish this movie, you cannot concentrate on anything. Went for a second show, finished that movie, came back and studied. Now it is not waste of time, yaar. It is like you are prioritizing. You know what is your strength, you know what is your weakness. You know how much break you need. You know where you can de-stress yourself. Do all these things. But everything should be oriented. Adukku every day you should not say, naalikku adutha run padam vandiruchu paakanum. Naalikku adumana then. The entire films, the only movie I seen was Alagi. For the entire movie, only movie I saw was Run. Okay, during entire civil services period, these are the only two movies. Because they were very good at that time and everyone we felt like, okay, we should watch it. So plan like that. Morning walks, okay. I wake up around 6 o'clock. I never used to read after 12. My roommate was like, no, he's a late night bat. He reads the entire night. I also got jealous one day. No, namalan 12 thoongirrom, 11, 12 I sleep. This fellow is reading for 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock. If he passes and I fail, and he's a bloody stupid fellow, only BA. I'm a BE. You know, I know more, three more alphabets there, more than him. I'm a pass pretty, I'm a fail, I don't know, then I decided, okay. Even padikirana, nana padikiran. So I was also sitting with the book. He was also sitting with the book, nana. 12 I'd see, I saw him that he'll feel tired. This fellow did not get tired. 2 I'd see, he was looking fresh. Nah, he was also sitting, nama and a kamiya. 3 I'd see, abdi okandrikiran. 4 I'd see, abdi okandrikiran. Then 5 o'clock I slept, yeah. Next 24 hours I was sleeping. Okay. Then I understood there is a pattern for him, there is a pattern for me. Let me not get into his pattern. Whatever is my pattern, let me go for it. Now I wasted 24 hours and the whole night I was not able to get anything because I don't have that habit of waking up the entire night and to study. So whatever, though I was keeping my book, see, remember, many a times we study 24 hours, we study 10 hours, we study 12 hours, we keep the book in front of us and we read. But whether you are really able to concentrate what is in the book and whether you are able to get it into you, if you are not able to get that thing into you, don't keep a book in front of you, waste your time, don't project to everyone that you are studying, just throw that book. Take a break, go for a walk, do whatever you want, speak over phone, do something. Okay, relax yourself, come back and study. Never study under stress, never study when you are not able to take something into your head. That is what many people do. They just keep book in front of them. That is waste. And internet. Studying in internet, okay. That is again, yaar. Maybe you may all think that is hi-fi, good, it has a lot of information. You don't require a lot of information. You understand, you are preparing for what exam? You are preparing for? Civil services is meant for? Civil services is meant for? Is meant for? Yes, ma. Solling ma, parala. You told something, no? I know. Basically, I'm a cop, ma. Hey, in the kai that you are doing, இது காப்பு கடிக்கிறீங்களா இல்ல ஆப்பு கடிக்கிறீங்களான்னு தெரியல. எங்க விட்டோம்? அவங்க கிட்ட விட்டோம். அவங்க கிட்ட என்ன கேள்வி கேட்டோம் அப்படின்னு? யா நோ, சிவில் சர்வீசஸ் இஸ் மென்ட் ஃபார் ஹூம்? அப்புறம் என்ன இங்க வந்து ஆடுக்கு மாடுக்கு கழுதிக்க கத்து கொடுக்குறோம் தம்பி? வாட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் பீப்புள் சீ? என்ன பார்த்ததுக்கு அப்புறமும் சின்சியர் பீப்புள் சொல்றீங்க. ஃபார் ஹூம்? ஃபார் த மீடியோக்கர்ஸ். ஸ்டடியில் யாரு என்ன மாதிரி, ஓகே, நீங்களாம் நல்லா படிச்சிருந்தேன்னு வச்சுக்கோங்க, இஃப் யூ ஆல் ஹேட் பீன் பிரைட் ஸ்டூடெண்ட், வாட் யூட் ஹவ் டன்? யூ வுட் ஹவ் ஜாயின்ட் டாக்டர் எம்பிபிஎஸ், ஆர் யூட் ஹவ் ஜாயின்ட் ஐஐடி. ஹவு மெனி ஐஐடிஎன்ஸ் இயர்? ஹவு மெனி ஐஐடிஎன்ஸ் இயர்? நோ ஐஐடிஎன்ஸ். ஹவு மெனி டாக்டர்ஸ் இயர்? ஒன்லி ஒன் டாக்டர். இஸ் நாட் எ வெரி குட் டாக்டர். ஓகே, நோ, நம்ம கிளாஸில் நல்லா படிக்கிற பசங்களாம் ஐஐடியும் டாக்டர் தானே ஆகிட்டாங்க. ஆமாம் இல்லையா? எஸ் சார், நோ. தென் ஹூ ஆர் வி இன் மை ஸ்கூல், இன் மை கிளாஸ்? ஐம் எ மீடியோக்கர் ஆவரேஜ் ஸ்டூடெண்ட். ஓகே, பட் ஐம் இன்டெலிஜென்ட் பாஸ், ஐம் பிரைட். தட் இஸ் வை ஹி பிகமிங் எ டாக்டர், ஹி வில் ஒர்க் அண்டர் சம்மன் ஹூ ஸ்டடிட் பிஏ. தட் இஸ் அ லேட்டர் பார்ட் ஆஃப் த ஸ்டோரி, வில் கம் லேட்டர். ஐம் எ பிரைட் ஸ்டூடெண்ட், பட் ஐம் எ மீடியோக்கர் ஸ்டூடெண்ட். ஐம் எ மீடியோக்கர் ஸ்டூடெண்ட். எக்ஸாம் இஸ் ஆல்சோ ஒன்லி ஆஃப் தட் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட், யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட். எக்ஸாம் இஸ் நாட் மெயின்ட் ஃபார் வெரி ஹை ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ ரிமெம்பர், சம்மன் ஹூ டிட் இஸ் இன்ஜினியரிங் can able to take up geography and psychology and able to pass the civil services exam. So you only need that much of knowledge. Don't try to do your PhD in that subject. Suddenly we get interested, okay, I'm my option is geography, I get interested in geography, I start reading geography, asamaya in the padam, then I start reading, okay, one particular chapter which will have only 20-30 marks, I'll read that for 2 months, main say vandrom, and I'll go and write only for that 20-30 marks. So don't do your PhDs. So all this internet and all these for those people who are doing their PhDs, we don't require that much of knowledge. Don't waste your time in browsing, don't waste your time in all these things. Whatever you need to read, whatever questions it will be asked in the exams, they are available in textbooks. Okay, so just go with the textbooks, read them again. Don't go for 3-4 varieties of books, it speaks about the same thing. அதுக்கு செலக்ட் ஒன் புக் விச் இஸ் குட் ஃபார் யூ, ரீட் தட், பி ஸ்ட்ராங் இன் தட், தட் இஸ் எனஃப், தட் கிளியர்ஸ் யூ. ஐ ஹேட் மினிமம் புக்ஸ் அண்ட் ஐ ஸ்பெண்ட் மினிமம் டைம், ஐ வாஸ் ஒன் ஆஃப் த ஹாப்பி லாட் இன் மை குரூப். நோ ஒன் தாட் ஐ பாஸ், வென் ஐ கிளியர் ப்ரிலிம்ஸ் ஐ தாட் இட் இஸ் ஃப்ளூக், ஏன்னா ஏபிசிடி தானே ஏதோ போட்டான். வென் ஐ கிளியர் மீன்ஸ் ஐ குடன்ட் பிலீவ், வென் ஐ கிளியர் இன்டர்வியூ தே ஹவ் நோ அதர் வேட் பட் டு அக்செப்ட் தட் ஐ மென்ட் லீவ். ஓகே, வென் ஐ ஸ்டார்டட் டேக்கிங் கிளாஸஸ் ஃபார் தேம், then only they understood, like, you know, yeah, this guy knows a lot in geography. When I cleared it for the second time, they said, illada unga nariya theriyum pola. It takes time, boss, for people to believe you. But what I say is, like, you know, civil services, make it simple. Don't expand yourself, don't strain yourself, be happy, study well, you'll clear. You agree with me? Huh? Were you doing some mistakes in the past? Will you want to change? Do you want to change?
Yes, sir.
You want to change, you change. You don't want to change, we'll meet next year. Okay, so my time is up. You have any questions, I'll finish it. Sorry, I'm not able to spend much time because at 4 again I have a meeting with my boss. You know, a lot of protest and agitation, that's why I was a little late. But since I promised, I thought, okay, I'll come and meet you. So I couldn't speak anything about police because that is not necessary for civil services. We'll discuss about it later. So I hope to see some faces in Indian Police Service, in Tamil Nadu here. We'll work as colleagues. So all the best for you all. Okay, any questions? You can ask me anything, yaar. I'll not mistake you. Whatever you want to ask, you can ask. It can be related to anything. Sky is the limit for a civil service student. Kelvi illaya? Illada na kalambidalama? Yeah. Enuma? பொலிட்டிக்கல் ப்ரெஷரா? அதெல்லாம் ஒன்றும், அதெல்லாம் ஒன்லி இன் மூவிஸ்மா. ஃப்ராங்க்லி தே நோ யூமா ஹூ யூ ஆர். ஓகே, யூ ஆர் குட், தே வில் நாட் கம் டு யூ ஃபார் எனிதிங் பேட், தே ரெஸ்பெக்ட் யூ அ லாட். நாங்கள் போலீஸ் ட்ரைனிங்கில் இருக்கும்போது ஒரு கதை சொல்லுவாங்க, ஒரு பொலிட்டீஷியன் வந்து ஒரு எஸ்பி பார்க் போனானா. எவ்ரி ஒன் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்ஸ் தமிழ்? ஹோ மெனி கான்ட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் இட்? ஓகே, ஐ ட்ரான்ஸ்லேட் இன் போல். ஓகே, a politician came to meet an SP. So he asked all his followers to stand outside. He knows he's going to request for some wrong request. So he went inside, he told to the SP, and SP blasted him. How dare you to come and ask me, da. This fellow came out, this politician came out, he said, calm, work did not finish. But officer, in other situation, he went, the SP knows he's a very powerful fellow. You don't listen to him, he may even get you transferred. He did it. Okay? So he came out with all smiling faces. He told everyone, work, but officer, there is a reputation. There was an instance for me. So when I was an SP, there was a minister's daughter in my district. There was no minister in the district. Minister's daughter was there. She was a powerful. So the day I joined, she invited me for a lunch at home, lunch or dinner. I never went. She sent messages through many, like, you know, she wants to invite me for a lunch. Then, like, she came to know that I have some college mates in that town. So she told to them, they also came up, like, even then I didn't go. Now it became like, no, very prestige thing for her, like, no, I should somehow call the SP. In between, there was a small dispute where she is on one side and then another fellow was on another side. So all my men were afraid to go and take up that case because they know that the moment you touch it, she'll finish you. I took up the case, did it against her. So she gave me a call. She asked me, like, na sonna poduma, enga appa solnuma, illa CM solnuma. Said, yaaradhu solla solunga paakum. You believe me, no one called me. Neither her father called me, nor the CM called me. No one called me. It was finished. That was all fine. After that, few months passed. One day, I was just getting dressed up for my office, and suddenly, Odeon said, the constable at my house, now he was trembling. Odeon, gidi gidi gidi, na yada abhi na. He was afraid to tell the name also. Then, he told the minister's name, daughter undirukanga. I was also feeling very uneasy, okay? I know that she's a very bad-tempered lady. I never allow any politicians to my house. So I was like a little bit worried. If I have to have a bad conversation in front of my family, my parents are there, my wife is there. Now, yeah, then it hurts my ego. Yeah? If she says something in front of my wife, yaar munadi sonnalum uttalam, pondati munadi sonnalum uttalam. No, like, no, I was a little worried. Ennada, office la nalla tackle pannirukkalame inga. So I came down. So she was sitting there. By then my wife served her coffee and all. Anakamma, enna ma, sollunga ma. Then she said, sir, my brother's marriage. I came to give you an invitation. I was a little relaxed. Okay. Then she didn't stop with that. She gave next dialogue. Ellarukume katchikaranga kudukranga. For all others, the other our political boys are going and giving. But for you, I said, sir, I told my father I want to go and give, so I came here. I said, okay, thank you, ma. Then she said, at least by this chance, I feel that I can see you. I said, okay, fine. Then she said, you must compulsorily come for the marriage. I said, okay, I'll come for the marriage. She left. I don't want to go for the marriage. Okay. Marriage was in my neighboring district. Unexpectedly, because CM was coming for that marriage, I was on duty. It was like, you know, very frustrating thing. In the same lady's house marriage, I was standing outside in duty. How do you feel? Like they show in movies and all, no? I feel like, no, whatever duty I will do, but this lady should not see me. Okay. So I went very far. I left my inspectors and all. I was standing very far. I was just managing. CM came, went. Then my IG said, like, as a courtesy, okay, let us also go and wish the bride and bridegroom. I said, no, I'm not coming. I cannot come. Especially this particular marriage, I cannot come. My IG said, no, yeah, he's a good fellow. It's not like that. Did he ever influence you for anything? I said, no. Did he ever spoke to you? I said, no. Did you had any problem because of him? No. Did you got an invitation? Yes. Who gave you an invitation? His daughter. See, for me only his servant came, for you his daughter came. And I was a neighboring district SP. He was the zone IG. Then why do you hesitate? Then he got a bouquet for me. There was no bouquet and all, only he was having bouquet. He said, you are not the only SP. Other SPs were all accompanying. We all go together. We all just wish, come back. Then he forced me. He was very, very close to me. I can't say no to him. So he held my hands, went. I went up in the stage. I was praying God, till I come out of the stage, this lady should not. I was praying. The lady saw me. The moment she saw me, she became like a little, the reaction was like, you know, now she's going to come and hit me kind of reaction. She came running to the stage. I was there in the queue, like, you know, my IG, my DIG, other another senior SP, next I was like that, she came and pulled me out of that line. I almost felt very insulted, like, no, I know that this is going to happen. I know that there will be some insult for me. I had a feel like she invited me for that marriage only to insult me. She's trying to take revenge. So she pulled me out. All were shocked. I have not told this episode to my IG and all, no. She pulled me. Although she pulled and dragged me to her father. Her father was standing next to her. She pulled and took me to her father. I don't know, she'll tell something, some ugly episode is going to happen. Then she told to her father, Yurdam Pangur SP, he's our SP. And his father told, sir, until you are SP of this district, I'll never make a call to you. My daughter clearly told, he's a very good SP, you should never disturb me. If I give you a call and give you pressure, my daughter will kick you. We are so happy to have an SP like you, and we are very proud to have an SP like you. So until you are SP of this district, anything you do on any politicians, I will not come for them. And he never came. I was there in the district for 2.5 hours. Now, should I say this lady is bad or good? This minister is bad or good? So this is the politician, boss. Politicians are never bad. Politicians are much better. They know. Until unless you want to become bad, they will not make you bad. When you want to become bad, no one can help you. That's it. When you are good, they'll respect you. Whatever decision you take, they'll respect you. You have doubts, you come with me, sit with me for a day, you'll see how they behave. They behave very, very decently. Okay? So, I hope that clears his answer. Nathambi, any other question? Only when you ask, I can tell you stories like this. If you have not asked, I would have not told you this story. There are many stories with me. What is there to handle? What conspiracy is it? That is what, see, many things. People speak without having any knowledge about investigation. Sometimes, people like to spread new rumors also. Because of all this WhatsApp and Facebook and all, we believe in those rumors. Scientific evidence is very strong. That will tell you what it is. The moment a doctor does a postmortem, the doctor tells you whether it is a suicide or whether it is a murder. The moment the doctor tells, it is a scientific evidence, it is closed. He can tell you why it is. It will be very accurate. It will not have a little bit doubt also. It could be suicide, could be Abdullah Arkar. There are very clearly and scientifically you can tell what it is. So these things are not to do anything with the investigation. Some pulled for some political malice, some people create issues. They also know what is the truth. So that is why when we go, when we speak to them, once they have created that impression, they'll make some fights and all, for some reasons known to them, then everything will be silenced.
Do you think that capital punishment is here,
I myself have done encounters, yeah. It depends, buddy. It depends. See, it depends. You can't say yes, you can't say no. It is based on a situation. As a police officer, capital punishment should be given only by the court. We are not supposed to give. So, you ask me as an officer, I should say no. Okay. So, only for a private defense, we should shoot. When in my first Naxal encounter, we shot three guys. All the three are Naxals inside forest. We brought them to the hospital. They themselves told, they are all alive now. They told like, Nanga sutta, Anga sutta. We have not done anything. So I don't accept it fully. Why will I run punishments on innocence? Could have happened, I don't know. So far, no one told me. Sometimes it could have happened also. See, sometimes, no, maturity also there. When I just joined police, if some fellow just questions me back, I would have slapped him. But now, even though he shouts at me, I will not mind, because until and unless he is not wrong. There is something like, you know, what the maturity is, now this protest is happening, right? It's happening in my area. I was handling this for last 10 days. We have no violence so far, right? So in Madras University, when all the students have been sitting for 2 days, when we were able to, you know, make them to come out, that means like, no, we were able to make them to understand what they are doing wrong only because of a peaceful talk. If I would have shown some force or something like that, it could have not happened. It could have aggravated. So you should have, first you should understand, a protester is not a criminal. Okay, criminal is one who has done something wrong. A protester also had done something wrong against law. This is law. Against this law, whoever violates law is a person who has done wrong. But everyone who has done wrong is not a criminal. Pretty, yeah. So, thiridravanukom, road la ninna kathravanukom vithyasam irukku. So initial times, now I am telling this is wrong, you go up in Rugon, you get matured, you get understand. That may require some 6 months, 1 year later. Could be in my training days, someone would have parked in a wrong side, I would have given him a slap, asked him to take his bike. I would have done it. But you ask me now, I will not do it. That's it. Anything else, boss? So we'll wind up? Yeah. Anything I don't like in IPS? See, there are many things I don't like. There are many things I love. Life is a combination. If I'd have joined a foreign service, my batchmates were receiving the Prime Minister. They were receiving the President. I was standing on the road when the Prime Minister is coming. I was not even able to go near to him. That is a difference between one service to another service. Right? But every service has its own unique good feel factors. So till today, I'm loving my job. I have all, thank God, so far God was kind of having all good postings. My reputation was fairly good. And I'm loving this job. So you will have few things, you know. I planned for my holidays. Suddenly, these protests came. This whole year, I've not taken a leave. I've not taken my family anywhere. Now for this month end, they're all waiting. Now I'm on the way here, my son was calling and asking me, Appa, poidu vama, ennik pa tour poro. I was telling, povanda, po. Appa, ennik pa, povanda, po. Because I don't know whether I'll get my leave sanctioned or not. So that also, again, only in few postings. If I would have not been in this posting and in some other posting, I would have got it. So that is by time. Namma nera non rikula. Illya. So it is not the system and all. Things may change. So police is a tough job, it's a tough life. When my neighbor, who is an IAS officer, was coming back home, you know, spending time with his kids and my kids at 5 o'clock, I come at around 9 o'clock when my kids have slept. Okay, he used to tell me stories about my son, rather me knowing about him. He says like, Shravan, Rama bright, I don't know whether my son is bright or not. You know, so sometimes that happens, but again, it is posting based. If I would have gone to some other posting, I know I can come back at 5 o'clock. There are a lot of administrative posts. Where if I go, I can come. So it depends like that. And the marriage. But again, the charm of uniform, charm of policing. You know, the tupaki abdi thodumbo or kick over on theriyuma. That you can't get in any other service. Nah. Eduthu vachi adu oru sudu sudumbo. That's beautiful. There are certain things you will enjoy in police and the marriage. So it is like that. When something is happening, the entire crowd is running out of that place, you go inside that place. I don't know whether you will come alive or not, you don't know. Whether you will be able to do something or not, also you don't know. So when the floods were in Chennai, everyone is running outside, far away from the waters. We were going towards waters. When tsunami has come, we were standing on the beach. We even without a life jacket, if it comes like, you know, even if you have a life jacket, you will get killed. We know that. But we were standing on that, whereas we evacuated all the officers in that road. Okay, that is a risk. You put it and you will like it, you will love it, you will enjoy it. So that you get only in police. So I loved it. Anything else? Yeah.
Sometimes you personally lose it. Which side is wrong, which side is right. But just because you are in the administration, you have to compensate also patients. And that kind of situation
can be a little more elaborate?
Yes, sir. In certain states of the country, there are being oppressed by the castings, but just because the castings has a political power over that areas, you have to compensate.
That is all impression, boss. With respect to police, if it is wrong, wrong. Sometimes, you know, as an SP, you may not be knowing, aware of everything. But anything you are aware of, you will not leave it. Anyone who is leaving is not a good officer. If someone is behaving like what you said, then he is not a right officer. Right? Anyone who is a good officer will not allow it. There are a lot of people. Tamil Nadu has many good officers. So we'll wind up, boss. Yeah. That was the worst time. After that, I decided I'll never do an encounter. Almost for 2 years, there were cases on me, inquired by a crime branch, high court, human rights. So I was going to the court. The day I did the encounter, like everyone seen me like a hero. I also felt like a hero. Normally, the movie ends there. What happens to him after that, no one knows. But for the next 2-3 years, I was going to the high court, standing in front of the judge. You know, he looks at you like a murderer. Okay, you have to face him. You cannot speak anything. So you have to prove everything. So that was a tough task. It was very bad. It was a very bad experience. So my juniors, anyone ask, I tell them, you know, as far as possible, don't do that. Because it may look charming, but it may go on any side. And as far as possible, like until unless someone shoots at you, someone is harming your life, I say them, don't do that. Just for your rowdy, suttukonu, adala, don't do. That will get into a problem. Okay? And you don't know, yaar. Someone would have done something, you would have shot him, okay? He also has a family, no? He also have a brother, he also have a son. There could have been chances that this guy would have also changed himself. Okay? Few cases are fine. But that should not get into your blood. You should not feel good for killing people. We are here to protect. We are not here to kill. So that should be very, very, very minimum. I had only one encounter, but unfortunately 5 people. Other encounter was like my team. He was an Excel. He shot, we shot. So one died. Another encounter, we shot them, but we brought them to hospital. They all got alive. So that's it. After that, I was in city, so had no much scope for that also. And it was all true operations. So to save someone you are fighting is fine. Don't do it for the sake of doing it. Purilia. What else?
How do you foresee that there will be a law and order problem?
You know, boss. The moment you are into police, you know. Something is going wrong. By standing there, you know, that may be sometimes because of experience, the momentum, the kind of people who are coming. I know, okay, if Shyam is present, okay, I can be assured. Someone else is present, no, he's a bad fellow. This fellow comes, he's greater. I have my intelligence networks. So I'll get information from them. So it comes through various sources. So by the time you know what kind of group has assembled, what is going to happen, there are many agencies to feed you. And first time maybe sometimes like, no, you depend upon feed. Second time, third time, already you have seen them. You have had dialogues with them. You know what kind of person. So it becomes easy. Right, thank you. All the best. Huh?